Hey there, YouTube. I'm Yukitsu. This is the Yukitsu Times. Welcome to my channel.
Sit up again since the Zerg chased them out of their old place. They say they've worked out.
Welcome to another level of Starcraft, some brutal difficulty, which is really taking it out of me. Anyway, we're going to head into this battle. I'll show you the cutscene.
Don't look so bad.
Yep, sensors indicate... Wait.
Sensors indicate bullshit.
The star's energy output just jumped 500%. I've never seen anything like it.
Slow down, Matt. What's it mean?
It means the star will go nova in a few hours. Meantime, the planet's getting bombarded by waves of fire. Fire. Why does it always have to be fire?
Better than flaming snakes.
We've got a significant cache of supplies planetside, so we shouldn't need to build supply depots.
Alright, so this mission is ultra tricky because it is so unlike all the other missions. But once you get used to it, theoretically it's fine.
Smack dab in the middle of all them Protoss.
Tal'Darine.
Can relocate and keep us just ahead of the fire, but we'll need to salvage everything we can't take with us.
You ain't seriously going down there.
Come on, partner. We got hours till that sun explodes.
Well, let's grab that artifact and get out of here before your Queen of Blades shows up looking for it.
That would have made this mission so much worse. It could already not get much worse, but it is possible for it to get worse. Okay, so I'm going to do a dry run of this, figure out what the hell I'm doing, and I will be back. If I miraculously am about to beat this the first time through, which I won't, I promise you that, I will just quit the game before I can actually finish. Okay, so I think I figured it out. Didn't take me as long as I thought it was going to, but, you know.
Hope you brought your sunscreen, cowboy.
Now ain't the time, Swan.
Relax, hotshot. I got something useful for you. Banshees. These babies can blow the snot out of ground forces. Got cloaking, too. Gotta love that.
I got this.
Whoa, careful of those Protoss cannons. They can detect Banshees even when they're cloaked.
Okay, what I'm going to do is actually wait around here. I'll cut this part of the video, actually, but I've got automatic regeneration on my vehicles. You can see it sort of ticking up there. I probably shouldn't have uncloaked there. Yeah, I think I would have been better off not cloaking there. I'm going to wait till this regenerates, because you need every sort of advantage, and I need to move out with these Banshees, like, right away on this particular mission, so I'm going to actually let them heal up passively, and then we'll destroy this, because the wall of fire doesn't start advancing towards us until we destroy that turret, so I'll be back. Alright, so, let's give this a go here. This is where we get our little base going. Alright. So this is a bit of an awkward mission.
Nice job. Let's get our base up and running, and get that artifact.
So this one's tricky just because you have to sort of keep building all these micro bases all over the place. I went back and made it so I can get medics from the other vehicles. Or sorry, without the building that you would normally need to get them.
Fire wave approaching.
Sort of muddling my thoughts as I do this, but there's a base over here. You sort of have to attack it quite early on.
We anticipated your arrival. Now you will pay for desecrating our holy relics.
Alright.
Oh, hell. Not these Tal'Darim guys again. They seriously need to learn when to quit.
Mineral field depleted.
Okay, so once we've gotten those, we're pretty much done everything we need to be done here. Alright.
Not enough minerals.
Let's see, let's drop another one of these. Get another two of those. We need to bring over one infantry unit over to there. Doesn't really matter what. Alright, so that's fine. Took a little bit of a beating, but nothing too serious there. Just gotta keep building. Doesn't even really matter if we destroy any more here, so we can bring these guys back home here. The reason that I'm bringing this guy up here is because eventually what's going to spawn is a bunch of resources for some reason. I'm not really sure why. But, yeah, you get a bunch of resources there. We don't want to, like, go overboard on SCVs.
Not enough minerals.
Yeah, here they are.
The doctor is in.
Yep.
Alright, so we'll go there. Drop the war pigs, we'll get the Hell's Angels. Because they're actually quite good in this mission.
I got my ears on.
And what we're going to need is all these troops, probably. I can bring this one over here, actually, as well. And get those guys. The reason being that we're going to actually encounter some of the sort of top-tier Protoss things. Okay, so I should be okay for just a little while.
Make an excellent location to move our base to. We just need to clear them out and take possession.
Affirmative.
Alright, so
transformation systems.
Can actually move those guys back there since they aren't going to be useful here.
Orders received.
Okay, and we can also go marching up here for a bit more research, as it were. Oops, that was my SCV. And those don't really matter, so we're going to move on back here. Now, I kind of need for my Banshees to do a lot of the work here. That's actually fine. We'll let all these guys finish up their jobs there, I guess. Actually, let's go ahead and do that. We're not going to have enough minerals for this, I don't think. Yeah, we don't have that, but we're going to go ahead and grab all our Banshees. We don't need to cloak them up just yet because they've got detection. And we're going to go ahead and destroy as much of that detection as we can here.
This Tal'Darim base is in a good spot for us. We just need to clear them out and take possession.
Alright, so let's see if we can't take out some of these scarier vehicles here. Okay, so we can now move in with our infantry pretty safely here. Make sure those stay down.
The fire wave's right on top of us, sir. We need to move our base structures or they'll be destroyed.
Alright, so let's get working on that. Let's start moving these base structures and especially all our SCVs. Okay, so you guys all need to start heading up there. Lift off.
Tal'Darim base has been cleared. Should buy us a little help.
Our warrior's sacrifice was not in vain. We gladly march towards death to ensure your doom.
What's going on?
He's a charming fellow, isn't he? Alright, let's get these guys up here.
Right. Yeah, right.
Base is under attack.
Not necessarily sure what. Alright, those guys. Well, there's research down there, so it probably makes sense for me to go clear those guys out. Let's go ahead and start landing our buildings. Go ahead and land this over here. Actually, just land this. I don't need anything fancy attached to it. And you want with this thing.
Who wants some?
Receiving. Engaging.
Now, we can theoretically actually use all these resources. We're going to go ahead and grab these things. Bring them down here.
add-on complete.
All right, who have we got over here? SCVs?
Go ahead. I can't build here.
Oop.
Yep. In the rear with the gear.
Okay, there we go. Get these guys down here.
Add-on complete. Not enough minerals. Not enough minerals.
Well, let's get our minerals accelerated here. Now, you don't actually need to expand to all these little places that you can expand to. There's a bunch of other little places that you can get to, but you can sort of ignore them. There we go. Eh, something like that ought to do. Still, we'll want to go around and just look for treasure, I think. I mean, you can definitely build more expansions, like it does help, but I think that's a little bit too much to manage them for me right now. I'm not, after all, particularly skilled player. Did pick out the one that had the resource, though, which I feel is pretty good. Alright. Let's move these guys up and around here. I don't really even know why we necessarily have that thing that we have there. Okay. What we want to do is sort of get ready to march our way over this way, and for that we kind of want to be doing... Cloak him now. That's good. What are you guys doing? Oh god. Oh, those mineral patches are going down really fast anyway. They tend to in this level. Like, they're not huge mineral patches or anything like that, so you kind of have to watch out for the fact that you are going to run through your resources very, very fast. Which is fine. I mean, we're pooling quite a lot as well, because we're just also not building that many new ones. Probably should have actually done the pylon in this case first, so we can get a little bit of gas over there. Let's grab up these guys, I think. Bring them around here. Don't need to send too many people for that. And we just want to be building up a lot of Marines medics at this point in time. We still want to be building these guys as well, but you don't have to have anything like tanks or anything like that for this mission, I don't find. You know, that's going to be fine, I think. We'll probably deplete that mineral field in pretty short order.
Mineral field depleted.
Got three in each of these, right? Yes, we have. Okay. Wall of fire is getting closer.
Holla back.
Been waiting on you.
Well.
You want a piece of me, boy?
You don't often want to get your base moving until, like, you've really scraped all the resources out of a place in this level. And there's some more dudes here.
Engine screaming. The doctor is in.
Armed and ready.
I think that was kind of the last major attack on us, but can't really remember for sure. Either way, let's get moving out, I think. I think we do want to. Okay, so we don't necessarily need our Banshees to be too cloaked for this one.
The doctor is in.
Kind of want to snipe up these things very quickly, because it stops them from not only powering their buildings, but also stops their warpings. Alright.
Is it critical? Mineral field depleted.
There we go. And we need to start lifting off here. Okay. Oh, you guys can get going there. That's fine. Might as well bring this guy over. You as well, and you as well. Okay. Got loads of SCVs milling around here, that's fine. Let's get all these guys over here. Oh. That down there. Land this over here. And let's land this over here, I guess. Alright, we don't need to worry too much about building SCVs. I didn't lose any this time, really.
In the rear with the gear. Bad news, I can't build here.
Alright, so you and you get working on those. And we just need to completely take out all of these resources, like, really quickly, again. That's what we want to be doing.
You gonna give me orders?
Using these helps quite a bit. Alright, let's get these guys around over here, because there's actually a tiny enclave of Protoss over here.
I got this.
Head on. Complete.
We can get one of these guys over to that. Back.
Engine screaming.
Okay. And this is pretty much all we need at this point in time, is loads and loads of Marines, stuff like that. Works just fine.
Go ahead. What's going on?
Alright, let's get these guys back here just in case something weird happens with this. I don't really know if anything can happen with it, but I don't think it can. Could work on also getting a few mech units just so I can spend the money, but I don't think I really need it.
Mineral field depleted.
Now the nice thing about this ball is that you can sort of assassinate that stupid what's his name? High Templar. That otherwise would have really wrecked my ball of troops, so it's a nice thing to get rid of him. Alright, so we got one more base to push through. We've got loads and loads of troops here, so we should be relatively okay, but we got time. Like, we don't need to rush it too badly. So we're probably going to let ourselves do this the somewhat more sensible way. You know, I have got so much money that I'm going to start building other units here. Just so I can get some of it spent, because this is our last push. Like, it doesn't even matter what happens to our base at this point, really. One of the nice things in this level is you don't have to worry about your supply, because you automatically get your supply. Oh, crap. Right. Friggin'. Okay, well, that cost us, but not actually too badly. Okay.
Mineral field depleted.
Gonna drop one of these over here-ish.
Ready to raise some hell.
A couple of these guys as well. I mean, we could also send this guy over to there. Put that hotkey over there. And I mean, we should probably start moving up pretty much now. There are probably going to be more Templar, but you know what? That doesn't really matter too much right now. Okay, this ball looks pretty good. And I think we can just brute force with this. Gotta kill those, Oh crap.
Ready to raise some hell.
Not 100% sure what they're getting vision on me with, but, whatever it is, it's unpleasant.
Engine screaming.
Oh, that up there, probably. Let's get rid of that fight there.
Not enough minerals.
Oh, crap. Alright, so we're almost completely out of resources here. Which I suppose is good. Alright, let's get these guys over to this. Try and take out these pylons. I'll stem this flow of troops that they're sending after me. Okay, there's the target. So that should be okay. And if we can just keep their probes from doing anything, then we win the mission. For example, here comes a probe. Alright, and there we go.
Okay, the artifact's secure. Saddle up, people. We're
you can see that there's actually stuff behind that just in case you try and do anything cheeky with your banshees.
We will pursue you to the end of the universe, James Raynor. 1,000 deaths cannot atone for your wanton sacrilege.
What an angry, angry fellow. Anyway, Seventy-five enemy units or structures. I don't think that would have actually been hard, given all I actually killed exactly 75. That's kind of hilarious. Okay, well, that's perfectly fine. So yeah, that one didn't actually take as long as I thought it was going to. Like, it was really hard the first few times when I was trying to figure out just what, when I was supposed to, when I needed to evacuate bases and stuff like that. But once I figured out, you know, stop building buildings for instance. Mobius rendezvous point. There's the Hyperion in all its glory.
Sir, we've reached the rendezvous coordinates. No contacts. Looks like the Mobius ship hasn't arrived yet.
That's strange. It ain't like them to be late.
Sir, Dominion ship's warping in. Manx's flagship is leading them.
Sweet mother of mercy.
Sir, their shields are still down. I don't like this.
Matt, pull us alongside and prep docking tubes.
Commander, this is not a smart move.
You wanted your revolution, kid. Now you got it.
This part's pretty cool, actually. I don't know, Blizzard always does really good cutscenes. I wish these actually existed in the game. Have a nice day. Doesn't keep his visor down, just doesn't care. Alright, this character I actually quite like. I don't know, maybe that'll change after the Protoss one, but so far he seems like a pretty interesting guy.
Turn around, Arcturus. I want you to see this coming.
You won't find my father here, Commander. I am Valerian Manxk. And I own the Mobius Foundation. Through them, I own you as well.
Tell me why I should kill you right now.
Because I can offer you what you've always wanted. A chance to rescue Sarah Kerrigan.
All right. In the lab, only 2 hours later.
The artifact fragments you've been collecting are of Zelnaga origin. With them, I can construct a device that will reverse the infestation that transformed Kerrigan into the Queen of Blades. You're the only man who's been close to her and lived to tell the tale. You know her tactics, you know her strategies. And I know you'd risk anything for the chance to bring her back.
Sir, right.
Tell me you're not seriously considering this deal with Valerian.
Sounds like a golden deal to me, Jimmy. Kerrigan turns human, takes a bullet between the eyes. You can put your past to rest and still make one hell of a payday.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves, Tigus.
Assaulting Char is a suicide mission. You'd be putting all our lives on the line just to get your girlfriend back.
This is bigger than all of us, Matt. It ain't about me. This is the only real chance we're ever gonna get, and I'm taking it.
So which is it gonna be, Jimmy? We bringing Kerrigan back, or putting her in the ground?
That's for me to decide. You both got a lot of prep work to do. Get to it.
And back in the bar while his friends are doing prep work. Alright, I think we got all of the Protoss research things from that mission, but maybe not.
This is Kate Lockwell for UNN. Tonight, top Dominion military analysts are still confused and relieved to report that while attacks do continue throughout the Fringe, the main Zerg push into Dominion space seems to have slowed.
That's wonderful news, Kate. Our boys have really taken the fight to the Zerg.
Of course, Donnie. But there's also a sense that whatever the Zerg were after, they either got it or they've given up on it. We may never know.
You heard it here first.
All right. Anyone to talk to here? Can we actually get any new mercenaries here?
Place.
Banshee pilots. That'd be interesting. Yeah, there are mercenary banshees. Plus 50% damage on mercenary banshees is actually pretty amazing damage. It's 18, I think. On two shots, so 36 up from 24. That's a lot of damage. That could be pretty good. We don't have a ton of cash, though, so let's go to the lab, see what we can scrounge up from them. Of course, we're also getting stuff from Stetman here. Alright, Protoss tank. This is the capped-out version of it. With all the containment and reinforced structural integrity theorems I've developed from studying this crystal are starting to well crystallize. I think we might be able to contain energies that once required huge machines or even manufacture structures capable of hot landings from orbital origins with acceptable stresses. I'm a sham. I haven't truly learned anything from this crystal. I've just observed the smallest details from it and somehow wrangled a few tidbits from the crystal. Helped me. When the crystal helped me. I don't understand how the Protoss can possess technology of this magnitude and not rule the known universe. Perhaps they simply don't want to? They don't really. Last entry on the sample, I figured out where it is putting all that excess energy. It's feeding the Hyperion, subtly helping to power the ship, balancing out some of the more ragged systems, giving it of itself, and has been since it got here. Swan is excited that the ship is running so well, but he has no idea why, and I'm not going to tell him. There's a black hole in your friggin' ship, man. Alright, artifact.
So these artifacts are the key to freeing Kerrigan. Pretty amazing coincidence Tigus just showing up out of the blue, offering us the job to collect these damn things.
Statistically, sir, the probability of coincidence is minuscule. However, these artifacts do represent a power beyond our current scientific understanding. If anything could give the Queen of Blades pause, perhaps these are it?
All this ancient alien hocus pocus is a little out of my pay scale. I just pray that when the time comes, these things bring her back to me.
All right, Jimmy, let's see what you can do here. All right, we got a little bit of money there. Oh, from both. Okay. Barracks units now arrive by drop pod. Drop pods land at the barracks rally point. I'm never going to remember to use this properly, although that's an amazing ability. It's practically warp in, except they warp in when you've finished building the unit. The other one is the tech reactor. Now, the problem is that I usually only need the tech lab so that I can build the barracks units, the medic from the barracks units. But the thing is, you can apply this to other buildings as well. So this is actually probably going to be what I get, just because this way I've got the tech reactor on my starport, as well as on for siege tanks, like double building siege tanks is the example here. That's actually pretty good, and the ability to double build banshees and stuff like that. The other one, I mean, Orbital Strike is pretty impressive, if I remember to hotkey my buildings and so on and so forth. And if you're going for a really marine medic strategy, then this is the way to go, because it lets you drop pod those units into combat. They'll be right where you need them, when you need them, and that can make all the difference, having those units as you're doing a push, instead of having to wait for those reinforcements to make it all the way across the map. But I think I'm going to go for the... I don't even remember what I took last time, but I think I'll get the tech reactor, at the very least this time. Alright, so that worked. Let's check the armory, see what we got for upgrades for our banshees. Oh, no, we can see the banshees here. I didn't get everything yet. Alright, created by the Dominion military to terrorize rebellious colonists, the Banshee is used to great effect in urban and rural settings. Its agile, sneaky capabilities quickly propelled it onto the front lines against Zerg, Protoss, and Terran foes. The D951 Banshee cloak generator is one of the most sophisticated pieces of equipment in the Dominion arsenal. When a Banshee is shot down, special teams are deployed to recover the generator or destroy it. Well, considering how fragile those things are, that must be pretty often.
So, what's the problem, Swan?
What's the problem? You only signed us up with our mortal enemies. Every one of these boys lost family or friends to Mengsk. We're gonna be sitting on a powder keg pretty soon. Can't you see that?
It ain't up for discussion, Swan. I gotta do this.
Alright, well... Yeah, no, he is actually, so far, you know, a better person than his father, but... Okay, these are actually really useful abilities in certain levels. It gives, like, the huge amount of just, damage potential to this, Banshee unit. Increases their range effectively in some situations, too, but this can really increase their damage output. Cloaking for twice as long, I mean, there aren't very many stages where the cloak works that well. So we're probably... I'm gonna leave these be just for now, because I don't know when I would ever have a chance to use those effectively, but... Those are definitely powerful upgrades. Why is it saying visit the lab? Pretty sure that I already saw that, so... anyway, let's head back to the bridge and
Sir,
see what we got here.
Transmission from the Bucephalus. Prince Valerian's holding on the communicator for you.
Alright, Horner.
I have to question your objectivity on this alliance. It's obviously a trap.
I got it covered, Matt. I'm asking you to trust me.
We were starting to make real progress against Mengsk. If we go after the Queen of Blades, we're throwing that away.
This is bigger than Mengsk. Matt, if we succeed on Char, we'll save billions of lives. Billions. Mengsk can wait.
I didn't sign up for this.
You signed up to follow my orders. If you can't do that anymore, then get the hell off my ship!
Sir.
All right.
You sure about this? You gotta know Mengsk is gunning for you.
Ironic that Tychus is saying that.
You'll never see coming.
I can handle Minx, Tychus.
Just watch your back, old buddy. That's all I'm asking.
I said I can handle it. If you don't want to be a part of this, you can take your 30% and go.
Wonder if you've actually been storing the money to actually give him.
Ah, Commander Raynor. I thought we might discuss the expedition to Char. Now...
This is a dangerous game you're playing, kid. What's your stake in all this?
Jim, I really think we should... I can see why my father wants to kill you.
I asked you a question.
Everyone wonders if I will be as good an emperor as my father. But I want something more. To prove that I will be a better emperor and a better man.
That shouldn't be hard.
If I reform the worst mass murderer in history, make her human again. Teamed with the famous outlaw Jim Raynor. That's all the proof I'll need.
So I'm just a cog in your machine.
If it gets you what you want, do you care?
Guess I don't.
Those are the best deals, is where, you know, you don't care if they get the thing that they want, and they don't care if you get the thing you want. Never works out quite that way, though. Anyway, let's check out the bridge and see what missions we've got. I don't think I want to go to Char just yet, obviously. Don't know what this one is. Core Hall we're gonna have to do.
We have the Odin. Now we can use it to spearhead our takeover of the UNN studios on Core Hall. Once the Odin has taken out their defenses, we'll broadcast our evidence against Mengsk. Figure they'll throw everything they have at us. They'll be talking about this one for years.
Okay, so this is the one where Donnie Vermilion works, but yeah, let's get into this mission and see how we can do it. I'm gonna, again, do a few dry runs, and I will get back to you once I've figured it out.
Our raid on the Valhalla facility hasn't even been reported yet. The Dominion have no idea we stole the Odin. I had to call in every favor I had, but I got the Odin on the surface with Tychus inside.
Matt, you're a miracle worker. Must have been a complicated operation.
You don't even want to know, sir. I'm not going to let anything keep us from exposing Mengsk.
So they're still expecting to film it at the UNN studios later today?
That's right. And we won't disappoint.
I like how those guys in front aren't information properly. Experience.
Tychus will pilot the Odin and hit the studio guards with a surprise attack. They'll be confused for several minutes,
and won't even know who to attack at first.
And during the confusion, we'll establish a forward base using this command center we acquired earlier. Pretty devious, Matt. I like it.
If Tychus can inflict enough damage during the sneak attack, making the broadcast should be relatively easy. Keep in mind, we'll only have a few minutes before the Dominion realize that Tychus is in the Odin.
It's a shame that you don't actually get to
use everything they've got to stop us.
Whatever happens, we'll be giving Mex one hell of a broadcast.
You don't actually get as much time as they're advertising, I don't think. But, yep. I'll see you as soon as I figured this out. Okay, so I think I've gotten the hang of this.
I'm in the Dominion security network.
And, yeah, let's give it a shot. Now. It wasn't actually as hard as I thought it was. This one's not too tricky. It's just I got caught off guard the first time by not building enough anti-air. And you need a lot more of it than I thought you did. Like, I knew you needed anti-air in this mission. I didn't think I needed as much as I ended up needing. I mean, there's an entire friggin' base dedicated entirely to making that, so you would have thought that would have been obvious, but not to me. For I am an idiot. Okay, so it gives you plenty of time to figure out, like, where everything is. I like taking out this base first, just because these, I feel, are the dangerous units. Even though, like, these ones are more annoying to sort of try to wipe out, the problem is that these air units are hard for the Odin to deal with, so you don't necessarily get the progress that you want. I can actually do this as long as I want until we get going here. This one I can leave alone, because the Odin can basically 1v1, like, the Odin by itself can take out this entire base by itself, basically, even when they're active, but let's go ahead and get this started.
Boom,
boom, boom.
This is General Warfield of Dominion.
I think I botched something because I'm taking a little bit more damage, I think, than I am supposed to for this part, but... You know, the Odin can get pretty low during this part of the game.
Heavy duty.
And if you screw it up, you kind of,
I like it.
You need to really be careful about how you're using your barrage ability, because it's actually really important, and it's also pretty important to stand next to siege tanks when you're killing them. That one doesn't matter as much. Now, they're sort of surprised, so they don't feel like attacking me right now. They're like... They're not sure what's going on as far as that goes. So I can get away with sort of attacking them, like this piecemeal. And they're just like, is it actually... Is there something wrong with Odin? Is it something wrong with us? Like, what's going on? Who's the traitor here? Alright, I like doing that so they punch up. And you can sort of take them all at once. If you take out a base pretty much entirely, then you get an opportunity to ignore that base completely. So you have to sort of hurry up and try and wipe out bases completely. Otherwise, they sort of rebuild a little bit. Alright, we need to use our barrage ability here. And that wipes all those guys out. So it's just anytime you see like a cluster of troops, you sort of go for that. Here, you could use it to destroy buildings faster, but it's not really necessary. You just do this so that you can take out those clusters of units, because the buildings go down really fast on their own anyway. You don't have to fully destroy buildings either.
Before they shut me out of their system.
Don't rush me, kid. Can a man take some laser in his work?
You just have to get them to the point where they're burning like that. Oops.
Heavy duty. Make room for the big dog.
It's the lovely thing about Terran buildings that they do burn, so it's not quite as necessary. Actually, I think I will use this ability here, though. Just because it all also takes those buildings out faster. Alright, so I think we're doing okay as far as time goes. Hopefully that will burn down.
Out of time.
So are these guys. Don't sweat it.
Alright, let's do that.
I like it. Heavy duty.
We need to shoot that once. This twice. That once. That again, I guess. Okay, that should have been enough to take out that base completely.
I can't track their positions anymore.
And so we won't have to deal with any tanks or anything like that. We just have to prepare against infantry, light vehicles, and flyers, which is kind of painful, but you know.
For our broadcast to reach all of Dominion space,
fortunately they don't build a lot of marauders.
We need to control each broadcast tower long enough to upload the data. Any unit type can maintain control.
All right.
You can bet Max will have something to say about that. Let's get moving.
So this is a fairly tricky... I wish those SCVs were actually working when you started this. Like, they animate them doing that, but... No, they're sitting here on their hands, doing nothing. All right.
Our base is up and running. I'm transferring.
So you can defend the first wave just using your Odin, no problem. Like, it'll have no problems with that. I did some upgrades. Like, I've got the tech reactor, so that should help out quite a bit in these sort of situations. Oh no, I told you guys that I got the tech reactor.
Hardware inbound. Stores are smaller than the Odin.
So I'm going to use this guy over this side to try and handle the flanking force if they come with one, but I think they do. Yeah, they do. Alright, let's go ahead and get a supply depot up there. Just want to build lots and lots of SCVs at first. Okay. Got lots of SCVs coming in though, so.
Add-on complete.
Okay.
SCV ready.
Right, let's grab three of these guys and start working on one of our gases. Okay. And I mean, this is going pretty well. I mean, I probably should be not clumping up my minerals like this, but it kind of doesn't really matter too much. We've got a bit of a glut of resources in a certain sense here. So it's not like those are going too much to waste, but I could start buildings, honestly. We'll definitely need a starport for this one. Sorry, it's like super important actually. I don't know why I said we might. Alright, there we go. Let's get this guy over here. Have him guard on that side. And we still need a couple SCVs.
The doctor is in.
Probably still need supply depots coming down.
SCV ready.
Alright, and let's go ahead and get this guy over here. Now, there are plenty of expansion spots in this game, in this map, rather, so we don't have to worry too much about the fact that it looks like we're going to run out of minerals eventually on this one. You do, but it doesn't matter, because you can go ahead and get plenty more. Alright, there we go. And it's going to cost us a lot of money to get this thing repaired back to full health. It did do a lot of work, so can't really complain about that.
The doctor is in.
Let's get another one on there.
Insufficient Vespine gas.
Okay, and let's get our gas filled up now. We still need quite a few more SCVs to finish this up, but it's not actually too bad. Alright, so I think you guys are done. Yeah. Those guys are done. Can ignore that. Getting more medics there, more marines. Always a good idea. Get some Vikings pretty soon here. And the thing is, we need actually quite a lot of Vikings for this mission.
You gonna give me orders?
This is one of those ones where it doesn't matter that I got the tech reactor, because I just want the normal reactor.
The doctor is in.
But, eh, you know.
We hear you.
Not enough minerals.
There we go. And as you can see, we're really low on all of our resources, but that's gonna fix itself pretty quickly. By which I mean, I'm a terrible person, and I'm not going to keep up my macro, because I'm just awful. Alright, looks like we're just about saturated. I'm not going to worry too much about one extra SCV, because, you know, it doesn't matter that much. Anyway, let's go ahead and move our medics to the back of this formation. And what we can do is we can actually start marching out with our Odin by itself. And what it can do is start clearing out space for us. Might as well get those. Alright. So yeah, what this guy does, he's just gonna pretty easily start destroying these bases. No problems there. And yeah, we can actually think about moving up and attacking that area just with the Odin by itself, so we're gonna actually do that. You just want to sort of walk away from this cliff edge, because otherwise the units on the cliff are going to just wreck you.
Make room for the big dog.
And it's probably a good idea to use your ability here when you can. Otherwise they'll just keep producing units and you'll be in trouble. Go. We need this to upgrade. Need more Vikings. And what we want to do is completely clear out that area before we even think about standing on that objective point. Because once we stand on that objective point, we're in a little trouble. It actually starts getting a little bit intense, so you want to think about the order in which you're doing things. Alright, so we want to sort of aim this here. I like doing this once we're on this movement to start wiping out these clusters of troops and, of course, the production buildings. Now, the nice thing is that these guys do practically no damage to the Odins, so this isn't really that big a threat. Now, let's go ahead and get our command center started.
Additional supply depots.
Alright, we need to build more of our supply depots in this gigantic farm that we're building.
Additional supply depots. Alright.
And we again want to use this ability so that they stop producing.
The doctor is in.
There we go. Just go ahead and queue this guy up to build another one of these.
Additional supply depots required.
And you can see that we're already starting to run out of minerals, but that's fine.
Can I keep it?
Just gonna keep on blowing up their stuff here.
A big dog. Hope this thing's insured.
This
better be good.
Alright. Gotta keep on building those supply depots, it looks like. Let's go ahead and get ourselves an engineering bay. We need to move these guys up to here, actually, because we'll get hit by an air attack pretty soon, but we also need some Vikings to go join up with the Odin pretty soon.
Heavy duty.
I think they're out of production facilities here at least, though, so
things insured.
That should be helpful. But when you're standing on that point, they send in big waves trying to stop you.
I like it.
Now, the airbase is actually a lot more trouble for your Odin. You want to attack the airbase using more or less your other troops. Yeah, so here comes an air attack. Now we're gonna back off a little bit here.
Victory. Bold. Ready to plunder.
And this is where it gets a little bit problematic. Let's go ahead and drop these guys. Let's just take out this battle cruiser real quick.
Fight or flight.
Yeah. And let's move these over to here. This guy over there.
Transformation systems primed.
Alright, we can start moving this thing up to here. We'll need to reinforce that thing quite a bit, but we don't necessarily have to panic or anything. I'm panicking a little bit, but you know, that's just me being panicky. Let's get a little bit of a worker thing going over there. We'll transfer most of these probes over there, though.
Ready to plunder.
Or SCVs, rather. Okay, I think that ought to be enough.
SCV ready.
Okay. So this should help a little bit with the current situation.
Better send some body back.
Want to avoid that thing.
Make room for the big dog.
The doctor is in.
Thought I sent more troops than that. Oh, that's a widow line.
By the numbers, boy. You gonna give me orders?
Okay, so let's have this thing walk over the widow line. Got.
Bad news. Hope this thing's insured.
Alright.
Armed and ready. Aye, aye. Fighter flight.
Okay, so we've got that relatively managed. Let's go ahead and get this done.
This better be good.
Need to repair that up as best as we can before we continue on, though.
Is under attack.
Oh, we're being attacked here. What's happening is there are air units that I cannot get line of sight to. So what we can do is we can comm sweep up there. Go.
Got it.
I think I must have stepped on a widow mine with my force that reinforced over there. Okay, let's keep building these Vikings. Keep needing them. Alright, so we're full health up here.
I
got a fairly small number of troops, honestly, at this point in time, but should be enough, I think.
Let's see what this baby.
Strike team Charlie, get to that tower. Bring down those rebels.
Armed and ready.
Okay, so they're sending in quite a lot of stuff to try and kill me here. And it's pretty effective stuff, too, that they're dropping here. I don't know who they're attacking that with. Damn. Alright, so they're attacking over here as well. Battlecruiser over here. Okay. I think there's a battlecruiser that shows up over here. Oh yeah, there's two of them in fact.
First transmission uploaded.
Transmission. There's only one man arrogant enough to think he can get away okay. with this. Rainer.
So that's nuts. That wasn't too bad.
Just for once, Arcturus, this really is all about you. I hope you enjoy our show.
I knew it. Warfield, get your men down there. I want Rainer's head, you understand? Him and all his terrorist friends.
Go ahead. Be in the rear with the gear.
Oops. What's going on? All right. And, yeah, we'll just continue on with that. Let's get more of those guys. Let's get another flight of Hell's Angels. Because they're actually, like, quite a lot better, so. Alright. I think we're doing okay here. We're going to actually recall this force back to our base. And we're going to start pushing around the next side here. And this actually is quite helpful, because if we're moving towards that sort of position where they've got all that air units supremacy, then we can actually stop them from making it towards our base, which means that we can just sort of push right at them. Alright, let's continue on with our production here.
Additional supply depots.
So as you can see, we've now got just tons and tons of these units here.
I am here.
Let's get the Odin start attacking this next base as well. We're gonna have to worry about it with our air force just a little bit. We need to keep it relatively close by, but you know, it's not going to be too hard to do that. We're also doing a little bit of movement with those guys. All right, let's get a couple of these upgrades here as well queued up. I mean, it's not a great idea to queue things up in this way, but it doesn't really matter in this case that much.
Ready to blunder.
It's kind of a shame that the Odin doesn't have the automatic cure that other units have.
Additional supply depot.
All right.
Hope this thing's insured.
There we go.
Got something for? I hear you.
And a couple of these guys, I think, ought to be a good idea here.
Mineral field depleted.
All right, so.
If this better be good.
Okay, they're coming around this side here. I'm going to try and intercept them before they can get here. Nope, okay.
We have come together to forge the violence and to deserve his red
threat.
Okay.
Vespine geyser exhausted.
Now we've used up all the resources here, so what I'm going to do is lift off of these guys and actually send them over towards this base here.
This baby's got it.
And what we want to do is start clearing out these bases over here.
It followed me home. Can I keep it? Make room for the big dog.
Now this base, it is actually an okay job to have lots and lots of Marines. Well, I think they just got mined, but let's retreat with this SCV here if I can. An interesting thing about the Thor is that it's actually a better anti-air unit than the Odin is, which is kind of weird, but you know, it is the way it is. We don't need to go there at all. And let's go ahead and let's get these air units over this way. As soon as they show an air unit to me, it's pretty easy to take out, but like, rest a little bit. It's a good thing that their aliens don't use their abilities like stealth. That would just be a real thing. Alright, my units are just all pounding away at them. It's quite nice. Alright, you guys, let's have you head over here. And you can land over here. Alright. That should be fine. Get a couple more of these guys. We'll get a couple more of these guys even. Not because I need them, but because I might as well.
Gangway, coming through.
So another horde of marines. We'll send them this way.
I'm wasting away here. In the rear with
might
the
as
gear.
Well get those guys there.
Not enough energy.
Alright, so what we want to be doing here is just getting all of our stuff fully repaired, getting some SCVs ready to go help. But for the most part, I mean, our eco is going smoothly. I can keep doing this, actually. We can move these things up to there, actually.
Upgrade complete.
You want a piece of me, boy?
Don't need this much of an air wing, honestly. I can probably stop building those. Need a lot more medics, it looks like. I think most of our medics got wiped out. So we'll work on that for just a little bit. Keep working on looking at our upgrades. Still queuing things, which is still bad, but it's not a huge problem at this rate. Okay, so I feel like we can probably get our units onto here. I don't remember if there even is an airway for this particular one.
Security breach at one of the towers. Strike Team Alpha, engage. Stop them.
The doctor is in.
Let's see if this baby's got it.
Alright.
I am here. Click me.
So it doesn't even matter if I lose a few of my units here, like even my more expensive units, like losing a couple Thors at this point, just because I'm only building them because, you know, I'm trying to get rid of resources here, but probably should stop that. Alright.
Big job, huh?
We're almost done transmitting Mink's dirty little secret to the Dominion.
Not enough energy.
So, yeah, we've got plenty of dudes left here. One of the interesting things about this place is that there's lots of these air defenses around. We can just go land and take them out, though. So let's go run over to here. I could also use a land unit once I got vision, but... you know, I'm probably going to do that, actually. Let's go ahead and grab our land units over here. Just move them up along beside it. Get a little vision with these guys. And that should be fine. I think we can probably see it from over here. Yeah. And we'll move these guys over this way. The reason we want our guys right beside it is so that we can fire as soon as we see it. There we go.
Let's see what this baby's got.
This just means that I don't accidentally fly my air units over anything too stupid. Oh, there's a little thing over there.
Can I keep it?
Alright.
You ready for war? Let's see what this
we actually haven't got as many ground units as I'd like, honestly.
Can I keep it?
The doctor is in.
All my air units do heal themselves on their own, so it's not a huge deal if I lose a couple of them. Alright, let's mine this out faster.
Not enough energy.
Let's go ahead and call ourselves in some more of these lovely mercs.
Depleted.
Go, go, go!
There we go. Another wave of troops that we can send to their grisly demises.
Been waiting on you.
And we'll start sending these over across to there.
Fight or flight.
So this last base should still be emptied out from our earlier attack. And, you know, that works out well enough for me. I don't remember if there's any research points in this map. I don't think there is. Let's grab a couple.
Not enough energy.
Go ahead.
Let's just grab a couple of these guys, a handful of them really. Send them up along with our tech blob so that we can make sure that we've got ourselves a little bit going on. And we'll rally those guys to there. We'll go ahead and make a couple more of these guys even. I mean, I probably have enough to hold out against the last wave. So I think we can go.
They followed me home.
This last one's actually pretty easy, just because we don't really need to... I love how there's those marines that just sort of walk up to the Odin and are just immediately wiped out. Alright, so there should be nothing left defending this area, really. If I did it correctly. Yeah, this is still empty. Perfect.
Made for battle.
Alright, so let's get this guy around here. There's actually going to be just a tiny bit of a bunker over here.
Watch this.
Much, much weaker effect, but still very effective.
They followed me home. Can I keep it?
This better be good.
Alright, so might as well get everybody onto there.
They're attacking a tower. Strike team Bravo. Take them out.
Let's just queue up everything. It doesn't really matter at this point because we've basically won.
Additional insufficient rescue gas.
Yeah, there's not a whole lot they can do to us at this point in time. I mean, you got these guys coming in fighting Odins and Thors. They're much, much bigger cousins there. You can sort of see the relationship there.
Alright.
Yeah, and there we go.
That's the last one. Let's see what the people will think of their beloved emperor now.
Yes, this one wasn't actually too hard. Didn't actually take me that long to figure out what I needed to. It's just, you know, the large amounts of anti-air.
Just got a UNN special bulletin about Minsk.
That was some pretty immediate anarchy. I wonder why everyone just had all those. Ooh, I have to do this in less than 20. I don't really care. That took way, way longer than 20 minutes. 35 minutes, yeah. But I'm not going to worry about it. Anyway, let's see how things are going. Can't remember if there's a cutscene after that one, but I think after that, if there is one, we'll call it an episode. If there isn't one, we'll still call it an episode. I wonder what Ron Burgundy has to say about all this. I actually know what he has to say about this, but I'll leave that to you guys.
Shocking revelations. Veritable firestorm of anti-Mengsk sentiment.
The Emperor held a news conference earlier today.
How do you respond to these allegations of genocide? Abusing aliens to...
I assure you, these slanderous attacks against the throne are baseless and irresponsible.
Sir, do you still stand by the sentiment that selfless devotion to the people is the basis of your rule?
Well, of course. I was called upon to serve the greater interest of humanity. Personal power was never my goal.
Then how would you characterize this statement?
I will not be stopped. Not by you, or the Confederates, or the Protoss, or anyone. I will rule this sector or see it burnt to ashes around me. I won't stand for this. You jackals think you can come in here and question me? This interview is over.
You know, I love seeing him squirm, but the Dominion's just gonna spin this like they do everything else.
Just say it's doctored.
Mengsk used the media as a weapon for years, and now we've turned it against him. One broadcast. You want us a bigger victory than 100 battles.
I guess you're right. Well, it's what we started this revolution for in the first place. We've got a long way to go. Maybe we started something here.
Hearts and minds, man. Just like you always said.
You know, Matt, someday you're gonna wind up leading this bunch of misfits.
Oh, no. That's what I keep you around for, sir.
Who would definitely probably be a more level-headed and responsible leader than Raynor would, but yeah, I still have no idea who they plan to rule things after they do their revolution. That's the thing about revolutions. A lot of the time it happens and no one knows who's going to be in charge. And it's really quite important to know that.
Kate Lockwell here, live from Corhall. There's rioting in the streets. Citizens are setting fire to government buildings to express their shock and anger at the startling revelations from earlier today. Donnie, what's the situation where you are?
I had a brother on Tarsonis. I had a brother there.
Right. Thanks for that, Donnie. Okay. Emperor Menx broadcast a statement earlier today. Unfortunately, UNN satellites were on lockdown at the time. Let's replay a bit of that.
This evidence has been falsified. The enemies of the Dominion will go to any length to soil my good reputation. These ruthless, slanderous attacks cannot...
At that point, the Emperor was shouted down. He's since retreated to his palace and refuses to speak to anyone. In this reporter's opinion, Emperor Menx has been revealed as a...
I'm amazed that she's still alive, honestly. It's kind of funny. Although, I guess Valerian probably likes her, but... Alright. What do you want, Swan?
You see? Told you I could build something better than that piece of crap, Odin.
I like that. That's the spirit, brother. Show him who's boss.
Got some work to do on the chassis still. But I got to thinking about upgrades and variants, you know? They ain't gonna be cheap, cowboy. Big honking thing like that never is. But they'll be worth it, you'll see.
That's what I like to hear. I'll take a look and see what's affordable.
I really wish I had some matches where the ghosts were more feasible, more viable, but... Alright, I think that counts as Dominion. Yep. Stuns central targets and does massive area damage. Destroyed Thors can be rebuilt in the field with the Immortality Protocol. Okay, so... This one is actually potentially really useful, were it not for the fact that I'm pretty sure you need SCVs and you need to rebuild them. So if you build a bunch of Thors, you know, you can reclaim them afterwards if you win. It's kind of tricky if you don't, but the 330mm barrage cannon is actually kind of good. We'll leave that alone for just right now, though. Close that up. I wonder if there's any... There's no mercenary Thors, right? Yeah, no, there isn't. Can't remember what the last mercenary unit even is right now. But, yeah, nothing going on in the lab. Nothing going on there. Let's just talk to Tykes and Horner.
So you're thinking about giving up this life of luxury and becoming a professional broadcaster?
Oh, regular folks just ain't ready for the raw sex appeal I'd unleash into the great little lives. I reckon my niche is right here with you, old buddy. Right to the end.
I'm glad you're part of all this, Tykes. You did real good today.
Got to blow up quite a lot of stuff.
Planning another strike against Manx?
Not just yet, sir. I figured we need to focus on the Zerg first. Overthrowing Manx won't mean anything if we can't beat them.
True. Freedom ain't worth squad if Kerrigan kills us all, that's for sure. Guess Manx.
Oh yeah, now you're dancing to a different tune. That's the problem I have with the cutscenes, the way they splice it together sometimes doesn't necessarily make the most sense. Alright, so this is, it looks like, our last sort of mission here.
Commander, our mutual friends at the Mobius Foundation have located the last artifact fragment. When this final piece is secured, we can proceed to Char and confront Kerrigan. Good luck, Mr. Raynor.
Battlecruisers. The Amato Cannon. I don't actually remember these things being very good, even in this, but... I can't remember if we needed them for this mission or not. I think you need them just because they're durable enough to survive... Because this one has, like, a radiation field that just encompasses the entire level. But anyway, that's our episode for today. I hope you found it enjoyable. And of course, as always, I hope to see you all next time.